Hello and welcome to Dark Age Ramblings. This is part two in a three-part series of what happens during solar minimum. In part one of this What Happens During Solar Minimum playlist, the NASA presentation stated that the amount of cosmic rays that reach our planets increases during solar minimum. This happens because the solar rays, solar radiation from our sun, isn't as strong. Something that is becoming more widely recognized as an effect of cosmic rays on Earth is cloud formation. Heinrich Svensmark, a scientist out of Denmark, has a theory that cloud formation happens more frequently because of cosmic rays. I want to briefly cover this article out of Science Daily. The missing link between exploding stars, clouds, and climate on Earth. Breakthroughs in understanding how cosmic rays from supernova can influence Earth's cloud cover and thereby climate. December 19th, 2017. The source is the Technical University of Denmark. This is a picture showing what they think cosmic rays interacting with Earth's atmosphere look like. Producing ions that help turn small aerosols into cloud condensation nuclei seeds on which liquid water droplets form to make clouds. The study reveals how the number of cloud condensation nuclei changes affecting the properties of the cloud. More cloud condensation nuclei means more clouds and a colder climate, and vice versa. Since clouds are essential for the amount of solar energy reaching the surface, the implications can be significant for our understanding of why climate has varied in the past and also in the future climate changes. So, Heinrich Svensmark goes on to talk about the changes on the sun and the ways that solar activity plays a role in the variations of the Earth climate. For example, the medieval warm period around 1,000 years ago and the cold period in the last ice age, 1300 to 1900 AD, both fit changes in solar activity. He says, quote, "Finally, we have the last piece of the puzzle explaining how particles from space affect climate on Earth. It gives an understanding of how changes caused by solar activity or by supernova activity can change climate," says Heinrich Svensmark from DTU Space at the Technical University of Denmark. So here's a couple of the takeaways from this video. Cosmic rays knock electrons out of molecules and produce ions. Okay. Ions help aerosols, clusters of mainly sulfuric acid and water molecules, to form and become stable against evaporation. This process is called nucleation. The small aerosols needed to grow nearly a million times in mass in order to have an effect of clouds. The second role of ions is they accelerate the growth of small aerosols into cloud condensation nuclei, seeds on which liquid water droplets form to make clouds. Low clouds made with liquid water droplets cool the Earth's surface. Variations in the sun's magnetic activity alters the influx of the cosmic rays to the Earth. When the sun is, they say, lazy, in a solar minimum, magnetically speaking, there are more cosmic rays, more low clouds, and the world is cooler. When the sun is active, a solar maximum, which is what we just came out of, when the sun is active, fewer cosmic rays reach the Earth, fewer low clouds, and the world warms up.
Please like this video and subscribe to my channel to find out more about the solar minimum, the grand solar minimum, and how you can prepare yourself for the times that are coming. It's getting cold out there.